Hi friends, today's topic is 0 by 1 knapsack problem using dynamic programming. So 0 by 1 knapsack problem using dynamic programming. So everyone know what is knapsack problem. Knapsack problem is we have n number of objects, each object having a profit pi and weight wi and a knapsack of capacity m. Our objective is to place these objects into the knapsack to get maximum profit. So place the objects into the knapsack to get maximum profit. In dynamic programming compared to greedy method, in greedy method we have three possible ways of placing an object into the knapsack. That means either suppose xi is the knapsack instance, either complete object is placed into the knapsack, or object is not placed into the knapsack, or partial of the object is placed into the knapsack. But coming to dynamic programming, it considers only two cases: whether complete object is placed into the knapsack or the object is simply not placed into the knapsack. And the procedure for calculating 0 by 1 knapsack using dynamic programming is simply, the formula is s power I plus 1 is equal to s power I union s1 power I. This is the only formula. By using this formula we are getting entire knapsack problem. S power I plus 1 is equal to s power I union s1 power I. Here SS represents in set format. Set means it is of the form P comma W, of the form P comma W. Initially S power 0, that is set 0, that is no object is placed into the knapsack. So we are, your profit is 0 and weight is also 0. Initially no object is placed into the knapsack, profit is 0 and weight is 0. So S power I, we know S power I. How to calculate S power I 1? This is the important step. So initially S power 0 is known. How to calculate, that means S power 0 1. So the procedure for calculating is, so to calculate S power I 1, we are adding the first two pair, that is the first two pair P1 W1 to S power I. Simply this information is getting S power 0 to the base 1 by adding the first two pair to S power 0. Consider an example to solve this problem. And before going to this example, knapsack also one more rule, that is purging rule. Purging rule means in the process of creations, consider a pair P1 W1, another pair P2 W2. Suppose if these two pairs appear in the sets, if P1 value is less than P2 value, that is the profit of first two is less than profit of second one, and W1 value is greater than W2. This means we are placing an object which is having more weight and less profit. That object has no importance. Simply remove this object from the knapsack. That is no need to consider for the next step. Now consider an example. In this example, so first to write the formula, S power I plus 1 is equal to S power I union S1 power I. This is the formula. Up to how many number of terms we have calculated? We have n is equal to 4. So calculate up to 4 terms, that is S power 4. That means first to calculate S power 1. S power 1 means S power 0, that means I value is equal to 0. That is S power 1 is equal to S power 0 union S1 power 0. Next to calculate S square. S square is equal to S power 1 union S1 power 1. X cube is equal to S square union S1 square. S power 4 is equal to S cube union S1 cube. First write this one. It is very simple to calculate what we have to do. Initially S power 0 is equal to 0 comma 0. That is, no object is placed into the knapsack. So we know s power 0. To calculate s power 1, we have to know s power 0 and s1 power 0. So s1 power 0. So the procedure is, add the first pair. Here pair means p comma w. We always consider in the format p comma w. So 2 comma 10. Add the first pair to s power 0. So to calculate s1 power 0, add the first pair. Suppose to calculate this one, add the second pair, add the third pair. That means 0 plus this is p, this is w. For profit we are adding profit, for weight we are adding weight. 0 plus 2 comma this is weight. So 0 plus 10. So the pair we are getting is 2 comma 10. The pair we are getting is 2 comma 10. So s power 1 is equal to s power 0 union s1 power 0. That means s power 0, 0 comma 0, 2 comma 10. S power 1 value is completed. Next to calculate s square. S square is equal to s power 1 union s1 power 1. S power 1 is completed. S1 power 1 is equal to, add the second pair. Second pair is 5 comma 15. 5 comma 15 to the s power 1. Suppose to get this equation, to get the second part, we are adding the corresponding pair to the first part. This is the first part. So 0 plus 5 comma 0 plus 15 comma 2 plus 5 comma 10 plus 15. Add the pair 5 comma 15 to each and every pair in s power 1. So we are getting 5 plus 5 comma 15 and 7 comma 25. This is the pair we are getting. Now s square is equal to s1, s square is equal to s power 1 union s1 power 1. S power 1 means 0 comma 0, 2 comma 10 union 5 comma 15, 7 comma 25. This is s power 1, sorry, s square. So at each and every stage we are identifying the purging rule. Suppose if any pair, consider any two pairs whose profit is less than and weight is greater than other pair, simply ignore the pair. And one more is, the capacity of knapsack is 21, that is the maximum weight is 21. Observe any pair whose weight is greater than or equal to 21, simply ignore the pair. So here the pair is 7 comma 25, the knapsack capacity is 25, but the maximum capacity is 21. So this case is not possible. So the pair is 0 comma 0, 2 comma 10 and 5 comma 15. Next to calculate s power 3. To calculate s power 3, s square union s1 square. We already know s square. For this s square, we are adding the third pair. Here the third pair is 8 comma 6. Third pair is 8 comma 6. For s square, add the third pair. That means 0 plus 8 comma 0 plus 6. 2 plus 8 comma 10 plus 6. 5 plus 8 comma 15 plus 6. So that means the pairs are 8 comma 6, 10 comma 16, 13 comma 21. So only 3 pairs, 13 comma 21. Now s power 3 is equal to s square union s1 square. That means s square value is already known, 0, 0, 2, 10, 5, 15 and s square power 1. That means 8 comma 6, 10 comma 16 and 13 comma 21. Observe the pair. So no pair having the capacity more than NAPSAC. So maximum NAPSAC capacity 21. This is up to 21. And check any purging rule. For example, consider the pair 2 comma 10. And suppose the pair 8 comma 6. 2 less than 8. Profit of this pair is less than profit and 10 greater than 6. So no need of 2 comma 10. Simply remove the pair 2 comma 10. So by removing 2 comma 10. Next, to consider if any other pair, suppose 10 less than 13, so no problem. Simple procedure is first to take one pair, compare with all other pairs. 0 less than 2, so 0 0 has no problem. 2 is already removed. 5 less than 8, 15 greater than 6, so it is also satisfied. 5 less than 8, 15 greater than 6, so remove the pair 5 comma 15. 8 less than 10, 6 greater than 16, no problem. 8 less than 13, no problem. Next, 10 less than 13, right? 16 greater than 21, no. Simple procedure is, first take one pair, compare this pair with the remaining all other pairs. If it is not satisfied, place them. If it is satisfied, the purging rule, remove them. By removing these two pairs, we are getting the final 0, 0, 8, 6, 10, 16, 13, 21. Next, to calculate S power 4. S power 4 is S power 3 union S1 power 3. So S1 power 3 is equal to, so the pair, here the pair is 1, 9. So 0 plus 1, 0 plus 9, 8 plus 1, 6 plus 9, 10 plus 1, 16 plus 9, 13 plus 1, 21 plus 9. This is the pair. 1 comma 9, 9 comma 15, 11 comma 25, 14 comma 30. Now S power 4 is equal to S power 3, that means these pairs 0 0 8 6 10 16 13 21 union 1 9 9 15 11 25 14 30. So observe the pair. This pair having NAPSAC capacity greater than NAPSAC, remove this pair. This is also greater than 25, remove this pair. So by removing these two pairs, finally S power 4 value is equal to 0, 0, 8 comma 6, 10 comma 16, 13 comma 21, 1 less than 9, so no problem, 1 comma 9, 9 comma 15. So to S power 4 is calculated. Now the final procedure, the final step is, consider a pair. If the pair belongs to S power I plus 1, consider in the last example, in the last step, the pair. So which pair we have to consider? The pair which has the nearest to NAPSAC capacity. NAPSAC capacity is 21. Observe the pair which has the weight 21. Which has the weight 21. So this is the weight 21. 13, 21. So 13, 21. Suppose if 21 is not available, check the nearest one. Suppose if 21 is not available, nearest one is 16. So now consider this pair. The pair belongs to S power I plus 1. For example, if the pair doesn't belong to S power I, suppose consider a pair, it belongs to S power 1, it does not belong to S power I, then corresponding NAPSAC instance value is equal to 1. So for this example, 13 comma 21 belongs to S power 4. Check whether 13 comma 21 is already present in S power 3 or not. So this is S power 3. It also contains 13 comma 21. That means The pair 13,21, that is the maximum knapsack capacity, is completed at stage 3. That is, by adding object 3 only, we are getting the knapsack maximum profit. So no need of fourth one. That means it belongs to S power 4, it belongs to S power 3. X4 value is equal to 0. X4 means first set 4. So fourth object is not placed into the knapsack. Now subtract 1321. So the final profit we are getting is 1321. It belongs to S power 4. It belongs to S power 3. Check whether it belongs to S square or not. So S square does not contain 13,21. That means does not belong to X square. X3 is equal to 1. That means by placing third object, we are getting the maximum knapsack capacity. What about X1 and X2? Subtract X3 is equal to 1 means the third pair 8,6. Subtract 8,6. 13 minus 8. 13 minus 8 means 6. 21 minus 6, 15. 21 minus 6, 15. Check whether this pair belongs to S square. 16,15 belongs to X square. So, sorry, 13 minus 8 is equal to 5. S square, right? Check whether 5,15 belongs to S power 1. It does not belongs to S power 1. So, X2 value is equal to 1. X2 value is equal to 1. Now subtract the second pair. Second pair is 5,15. That is 0,0. Check whether it is belongs to S power 1. 0,0 belongs to S power 1, right? Belongs to S power 0. Yes, belongs to S power 0. That means X1 is equal to 0. X1 is equal to 0. This is the final answer. So the simple procedure, that is the knapsack instance is 0,1,1,0. So the procedure to calculate knapsack instance is, in the last expression, suppose this example S power 4. If a pair belongs to S power 4 and the pair belongs to S power 3, this X value is equal to 0. That means X4 value is equal to 0. Now the pair belongs to S power 3. If the pair does not belong to S square, now this value is equal to 1. That is, by adding third object, we are getting the maximum profit. X3 is equal to 1. Subtract the third object from this one. Third object pair is 8,6. By subtracting this, we are getting 5,15. So to check 5,15 in S square, so it belongs to S square. So yes, it belongs to S square. Check whether it belongs to S power 1 or not. It does not belong to S power 1. So X2 is equal to 1. Subtract second pair 0,0. It belongs to S power 1. Right. Check whether it belongs to S power 0. It belongs to S power 0. So X1 is equal to 0. Final knapsack 0,1,1,0. And the profit we are getting is, first object is not considered, second object 15. Third object 6, total 21. So weight is 21, and the profit for second object 5 plus 8. So we are getting a profit of 13. Observe the pair 13,21. This is 0 by 1 knapsack problem using dynamic programming. Thank you.